I begin to open your mouth and bless the Lord. Come on and bless the Lord. Come on and bless the Lord. Hallelujah. 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 Glory to God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. 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 Glory to the Lamb. Glory, you're worthy. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Father, we're in place to worship you and exalt you. We're in place to give you praise. We're in place, Lord God, to sing of your wonderful mercy. Lord, and we thank you. Yes, 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 yes. Oh, Father, even as we prepare to go on Facebook Live, even as we're here on Zoom, Lord, you get the glory out of our worship. Even as we're now, Lord God, on Periscope, and now, Lord God, beginning to go forth on Twitter, Father, we praise you, we bless you, we lift you up. We hold you in highest esteem and highest value. Lord, your worth is beyond rubies, it's beyond diamonds. Lord God, your praise is in this room even now. Father, we bless you, Lord God. We glorify you. There is no God like you. There is no God but you. Men make gods, but Lord God, no one can compare with you. Nobody can, Lord, live up to you. You are the faithful God, the awesome God, the mighty God, the everlasting God. Father, we thank you today. We honor you today. We magnify you today. We lift you up today. We worship you today. Lord, this is the day that you have made. We do rejoice and we're glad in it. Somebody give God glory. You don't have to wait till we start. Actually, we are starting. We are officially, my God, in worship. Come on, somebody, as you're tuning in with us on Facebook Live, as you're tuning in with us, my God, wherever you may be tuning in, know that God is faithful. Know that God is good. Know that God is awesome. Know that God is worthy of the praise, worthy of the glory, worthy of the honor. He alone is faithful. He alone is awesome. He alone is mighty to save. He alone is great and greatly to be praised. He alone, my God, is a God of all gods. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Come on, let's worship. Let's worship. Come on, let's worship. Come on, lift him up, lift him up. Hallelujah. Give God praise. Come on, let's wake up in here today. Come on, let's put them hands together. Come on, everybody. Hallelujah. Come on, put them hands together. Come on, we're going to move today. Everybody, let's move something. Give God praise. Hallelujah. Glory to God in the highest. We give him praise. We give him glory. And we say, the Spirit of the Lord comes upon my heart. I will dance like David danced. When the Spirit of the Lord comes upon my heart, I will dance like David danced. Hey! Oh, come on, everybody.
Dance like David danced.
Come on, move your feet. Put those hands together. Yay! Pray like David, pray. to you. God has been faithful to all of us. Come on, put those hands together and say, I will.
I will dance.
I will dance.
I will dance.
I will dance. Yes. I will move my feet and give it to the beat. I will give him glory. Yes, I will. Yes, I will. I'll give God thanks. Yes, I will. He deserves a dance. Yes, I will dance. I will dance. If you've been through what I've been through, you'll be dancing too. I will dance.
I will dance.
I will dance. I will dance. Oh, come on, lift them up. I will dance. Take it up. Come on, everybody. I will dance.
I will dance.
I will dance.
I will dance.
I will dance. Oh, come on, life goers. I will dance.
I will dance.
I will dance. Yes, I will. Yes, I will. Yes, I will. Yes, I will. Oh, oh, oh.
God is faithful. God is awesome. God is merciful.
Come on, give God praise. Give God praise. Give God praise. Don't you sit there. Don't you just let me praise about myself. I am not your cheerleader. I just want to tell you, God is worthy of the worship. My God, my God, my God. Elder Levina, get ready to come take this thing. I'm ready to fly off in here because God is worthy. Hallelujah. Elder Levina, you got this. You got it. Lord, have mercy. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Glory, glory. Hallelujah. 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 The Lord is worthy to be praised. Good morning, Life Builders. How are you doing today? It's such a pleasure to be with you at this time, to stand in the presence of a holy God, to worship at his mountain. Somebody praise the Lord with me. Father, you are awesome in this place. Good morning. Welcome to anyone who's visiting with us, who's joining us for this service. We thank you. We praise God for you. We are so awesome. It's so awesome that you took the time just to spend this with us. We know that you had choices, whether it be somewhere in person or anywhere else on the net. We are humbled that you took the time to spend it with us in the presence of God. So we thank you and we honor you for coming with us today. We are so excited. We have such an expectation in our heart for what God is going to do today. We never come into his presence without an expectation of knowing, one, he's going to meet us here, and two, we will leave here better than we came. So we thank you for this. Father, the word of the Lord comes from Philippians 4 today, for the first verse down through the 8th. I'm reading the Amplified Bible. Actually, we're going to start at verse 4. Rejoice in the Lord, delight, take pleasure in him. Again, I will say, rejoice. Let your gentle spirit be gracious, unselfish, mercy, tolerance, and patience be known to all people. The Lord is near. Do not be anxious or worried about anything, but in everything, every circumstance, every situation, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, continue to make your specific request to God. And peace of God, the peace which reassures the heart, that peace which transcends all understanding, that peace which reassures the heart, that peace which stands guard over your heart and your minds in Christ Jesus is yours. Finally, brethren, verse 8, believers, whatsoever is true, whatsoever is honorable and worthy of respect, whatsoever is right and confirmed by God's word, whatsoever is pure and wholesome, whatsoever is loving and brings peace, whatsoever is admirable and of good repute, if there is an excellence, If there is anything worthy of praise, think continually on these things. Center your mind on them and plant them in your heart. You know, I woke up this morning and this scripture just was screaming, literally screaming, like if it was amplified in my ears, that there are times, especially in this season coming out of the pandemic shutdown and just the hard shift that the world is taking, and even the continual shifts that are going on, it's very easy to become anxious, to become overwhelmed, to become worrisome. But this scripture lets us know that if we focus on Christ, if we focus on the things of God, if these are the things that we start our day off with, that if we put them in our mind's eye, if we speak them out of our mouth, we have an assurance, we have a peace, a peace that surpasses all human understanding. Even in the midst of a storm, even in the midst of a swirl, we know that we know that we know we have the assurance of a God who sits high and looks low, who's concerned about even the smallest thing on our hearts, in our lives. There's nothing happening under the sun that he does not know about. There's nothing happening in your specific situation that he has not already established an appointed time and an appointed answer. So we give God praise. We give God thanks. We just exalt him for being Abba Father all by himself, for knowing that there is nothing too hard for him. Nothing in my world, nothing in my specific situation is getting past him. And he will move for me. He will move in me. He will bring a peace of rest and assurance to my heart, to your heart, to our hearts today. We have an expectation that the word that comes forth today will be a right now word to our situations. So join me in corporate prayer. Father, we bless you. We praise you. We exalt you, O God. You alone are worthy of our highest praise. You alone are worthy of our worship. We bow at your feet, O God. We humble before you, O God. We know that we know there is none like you, O God. We thank you right now that you are sovereign, that you sit over our lives, that you have your being in us, that we move according to you, O God. Father, we ask right now that you would release your right now word, O God, to speak to our situations, O God, to calm our hearts, O God, to dissuade our anxiety, O God, our worrisomeness, O God, that you already know what's coming, O God, and you've already prepared a place for us, O God, that you've already prepared a way for us, O God. So we thank you right now, O God, for that preparation. We thank you right now, O God, for making a way. Father God, if there's anything in us that keeps us from coming into alignment with you right at this moment, oh God, we ask right now, oh God, that you would just begin to move and shift those things, oh God. Begin to show us those areas, oh God, where we need to yield it to you, oh God, so that we may come fully holy unto you, oh God, just as a child, oh God. Father, just laying down all weights and all sundries, oh God. We thank you right now, if there's any ought that we have against a brother, a sister, a mother, a father, oh God, anyone, our boss, anything that is separating us right now, oh God, we release that to you, oh God. We release it right now, oh God. Father, we thank you for your peace that surpasses all understanding, oh God. Father, we ask right now for your blessing on this service, oh God. We ask right now that you would just move on the speaker today, oh God, that they would be able to bring your word with a liberty, a word that would go straight to the hearts of men, oh God, that it would sink deep and take root, oh God, that it would find good ground, oh God, to grow, to flourish, to see a fruit from, oh God. We touch not your anointing. We touch not your glory, oh God. We decree and declare miracles, signs, and wonders, oh God. We decree and declare, oh God, that you are moving even now on the hearts of man, that you are moving on the minds of man, oh God, that you are regulating that which needs to be regulated and brought unto subjection to you, oh God, at this time. Father, we thank you and we bless you as we move forward in you, oh God, as you begin to chart the course, oh God, that we walk in it, oh God, that we walk lockstep with you. We thank you for your leading and your guiding, not only on this day, but in the weeks to come, oh God, we thank you right now, oh God, that even as the world around us continues to shift and continues to quake, oh God, that we stand steadfast and unmovable in you. This and all things in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Father, we thank you right now for this time as our chronicler will put up our declaration. Everyone would please join me. Life Builders Church is a church and ministry focused on the agenda of the kingdom of God. We are corporately called to transform lives and build people to know their purpose and to take their place as productive and purpose-filled citizens of the kingdom of God. We have God's mandate. We have all necessary components in place, inclusive of power, provision, personnel, and people. We have everything we need. Let's shout that again. We have everything we need. One more time. We have everything we need. We have all that God ordained for us to have, possess, and obtain for his purpose. We are a stable house with longevity. We are relevant. We are vibrant and fresh. We walk in agreement with God's agenda and plan for this house, and we impact this generation for his glory. 2021 is our year to recover all and progress forward.
My God, beloved, we worship God today. We bless him in this sanctuary. We take this time to ask you to prepare this coming Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. We will be in revival. We're calling it a season of brainwashing. You know, every time you come through a season of pandemic, peril, trial, tribulation, whatever you want to call it, we believe God is bringing us out. We know this pandemic has taken much, but God has more in store. Can we prepare our hearts to worship? You see the information there on your screen. This Wednesday at 7 p.m., Dr. William Spence, powerful man of God. Thursday, the 20th, 7 p.m., the woman of God, Pastor Sandra Morgan Holly. And then Friday, closing it out at 7 p.m., Dr. Jonathan Briggs. You see the login information. It's free. All seats are free. You know what I would love? I would love for us to overrun the Zoom. We have space for you. Come and prove it. Try it out as we elevate in the worship. Again, our brainwash time. Renewing our minds in Christ and allowing us to move forward. But right now, can I get you to lift your hands? Can I get you to worship God? Can I get you to open your mouth and declare the faithfulness of God? He is worthy. He is awesome. He is mighty to save. Come on, let's prepare to bow our hearts to God and bow our very minds. And let's give God glory. Bow down and worship him. Worship him. Hallelujah. Oh, worship him. Bow down and worship him. Enter in. Oh, enter in. Come on, help me sing it, everybody. Worship him. Come on. Worship him. Come on, you can lift your hands as you bow your heart. Bow down, bow down, bow down and worship. Oh, enter. Come on.
God, let's say it together. Bow down and worship him. Lord, worship him. Oh, worship him. Hallelujah. Bow down. Bow your fears. Bow your doubts. Bow your mind. Bow your worries. Oh, come on, let's call him who he is. Consuming fire. Sweet perfume. Your awesome presence.
Coming in a moment, but beloved, I just want to encourage you as we set up this podium, my God, for her comfort. We want the Lord to get the glory in this worship today. We want God to have his way. You know, beloved, as Pastor Al is coming, baby, I hope you don't mind me taking this one moment to say this. Beloved, hear me closely. God cannot bless you at the level he wants to, as long as in your heart there's unforgiveness. Hear what I'm saying. Some of you need to forgive yourselves today. This word has been coming to loose you, to set you free, to give the enemy no place. The Bible says give no place to the devil. He don't measure out what he wants. He wants you completely turned off to God and turned on to him, and to fail and to fall and to be destroyed. But I wish somebody today would say, I'm determined to give the devil nothing. Pastor Al is the founding pastor of this church along with myself. She's labored in the heat of the day, in the cool of the night. If it were not for her support and her standing with me, I couldn't be here today as your pastor to declare the grace of God. There's a word from the Lord. I want you to hear it, and I want you to receive it. Let's thank God for the woman of God. You're looking beautiful this morning, as always. There's nothing wrong with looking beautiful in the presence of God. Nothing wrong with dressing up and decorating this wonderful tree that you are to me, a life tree. Come and bring the word, baby. I'm sorry. I don't want to get you distracted.
Glory, praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Consuming fire, sweet perfume, your awesome presence, fill this room.
Hallelujah.
Consuming fire, sweet perfume, your awesome presence, fill this room.
Hallelujah.
This is holy ground. This is holy ground. This is holy ground.
Jesus, we invite your presence
Oh, thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you, God, for your presence. Thank you 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 for gracing us with your presence. Thank you for coming in the room and sitting in this place. Sit amongst us. Have your way. Let no flesh be glorified in your presence. I'm your handmaiden. I yield to you right now, this day, this hour, this time. I yield before you. I yield this day. I yield this moment. Touch your people. God, thank you for fresh impartation to give them what they need, wherever they are in their state in life. Give them what they need. God, I thank you. Let all of you be seen and heard, and absolutely none of Althea. In Jesus' name, amen, amen. God bless you. Amen. This is the day the Lord has made. Amen. I just want to take this time and shout out to Bishop Carrington for the last couple of weeks, how you've been leading us to the throne before the Lord. Amen. In worship. Oh, I am so blessed. I missed you not leading worship. Or I miss when you don't, and it's been a while, but I just thank God for your obedience and for how God has anointed you, amen, to bring forth worship, to lead us in worship, amen. So listen, it has been just an awesome time coming before you for the last couple of weeks. Thank you for your all of your feedback and how you've been sending texts and sending words and about and your notes and what you're learning and how you're growing and how God is developing you. That is very encouraging to see you speak back to me. I didn't ask you to do it. You just did it on your own. But thank you so much for the words of encouragement. That lets me know somebody's growing and you're thirsty and you're growing and you really mean business about this thing and about forgiveness and what God's word says about any subject for all that matter. Amen. I know Bishop gets feedback. Amen. Also for messages. But I just want to give a shout out to you for your comments and for to let me know you're understanding, you're getting it, and you're putting it into practice. All right, so listen, before I go any further, I want to share with you something that you're going to be getting. This, it's a brace. I'm wearing one. It's one of those those name bracelets, and it says, these little bracelets, I want you to wear them. It says, forgive and free yourself and others from prison. And this is just my little gift to you. And, you know, sometimes we just need a reminder about what God's word says about our lives. We just need a little nudge. And, you know, they talk about, you know, how an elephant can be trained in like 21 days to train, you know, anytime you want to present a new habit, to form a new habit in your life, that sometimes you need like a reminder to do that, right? So I want to give this to you. It's going to be coming in the mail. It doesn't cost you anything. I already have them packaged up to put in the mail this week, and it's coming to you. And I want you to wear it to remind yourself that you're putting it into practice. Amen. Amen. So listen. So for the last couple of weeks, we've been talking about forgiveness, and last week we talked about unforgiveness. We're going to do a little review, but before I get into the review, I just want to bring in one little point that God shared with me this week, and it's coming from Psalms 1:1-3, and it says that, amen, blessed, fortunate, prosperous, and favored by God is the man who does not walk in the counsel of the wicked, all right, or follow their example, nor stand in the path of sinners, nor sits in the seat of scoffers or ridiculers. All right, but his delight is in the law of the Lord, and on his law, his precepts, teachings. Amen. In his law, precepts, teachings, he habitually meditates on what? The word of God day and night. Verse 3 is what I'm really wanting to just really get to you. And it says, and he, meaning the man of God who delights in the Lord, the man, amen, the man who does not seek the counsel of the ungodly or the wicked, he shall be like a tree firmly planted where? By the streams. You know, streams of water move. They move, they flow, they're fresh, they're clean, they're clear. You don't want to ever drink from water that's standing still. You're going to get sick. But if you were maybe hiking or somewhere and you're in walking and you see streams of water rushing through, amen, pretty sure most likely you can get some good water there. All right. So they says which streams or which yields its fruit. It also yields fruit in its season. The man, amen, that is fortunate, prosperous, who does not walk in the counsel of the wicked. Amen. He yields fruit when in his season, after his kind. All right. And whatever he does prospers, comes to maturity. And the Lord just showed me how we, when we walk in forgiveness, we're like streams. Streams where people can drink from. Streams, fresh running clear water where people can drink from. But we got to drink from the stream, the everlasting stream, in order to be equipped and to be prepared for those who are going to need. Someone's going to need something we have in us. They're going to need some encouragement. They're going to need some words. They're going to need some, just a push. And they may be depending upon us. But as we seek the everlasting stream, we delight, meaning we're happy. We get the word in us. We feed on the word. Amen. That we'll be like a stream when others are passing by. We can impart in them. Well, that's what forgiveness does. Forgiveness is like a free running stream that feeds others. Amen. And that's because we've been connected to the source. All right, and I also like that our leaves won't prosper and will bring forth good fruit. Amen. In the right season, after our kind. All right, I love that. Amen. So, amen. We also learned last week, or we learned over the couple of several weeks about forgiveness, what forgiveness is. All right, it releases, of course, a fresh stream so others can drink. But also, we also know that, amen, forgiveness is a gift from God, right? And we also know that the early church, they believed what? In radical forgiveness, radical healing, radical prayer. They were bold in their faith. We ought to be bold in our faith. We ought to be bold. Oh, yeah. We ought to be bold in our faith. Not little mealy mouth, but we ought to be bold. And we get the confidence we need by getting into the word and allowing the word to feed us. We forgive because we value, put a worth on our relationship with the Lord. Amen. And we want to please him and we love him. All right. We all have the capacity, right? We all have the ability and the capacity to forgive. It's a matter of hooking up to the source. All right. Sometimes we know, we say forgiveness can what? Be hard. It could be hard because of a difficult past or childhood or an experience, right? It can be difficult. It can also be difficult because sometimes, you know, when you lose a loved one, and for whatever reason, depending on the state of the situation, how they left or what happened, what transpired, as a result, sometimes we're just mad. We're mad at them for leaving. We're mad at God because we say he took them, which he did not take them, all right? All right? But all right, we're just mad. And we're walking in unforgiveness, all right? All right, but so, you know, sometimes it can be hard, right? It can be hard. We understand that. But when we forgive, we are sowing into not just our present, but our future. And not only us, but when we forgive the other person, we're also sowing into not only our lives, but we're sowing into their lives. Because we're not going to be selfish about this thing. Because when we really walk in the love of God, we want others to be free. We want others to walk in love and walk in forgiveness, right? So we all can forgive, but in order to forgive freely, we gotta practice it, y'all. We gotta practice it. We gotta put it into action on a daily basis. Amen. Forgiveness brings freedom, we said. It brings freedom. It means, amen, we are not bondage or slaves to sin. All right? It's not just a destination, but it's a journey, meaning we're always going to be walking in forgiveness. We're always going to be walking and walking out reconciliation, repentance, and forgiveness. So we just need to just cool our heels and chill, because forever, when we live this walk, this earth, and walk our walk, and we're engaging in conversation and relationships, it's always going to be something that comes up. But when you have knowledge and you know better, you can do better. All right? Is that right? If you know better, you can do better. That's what our bishop says. All right. So we know we have an incredible, an awesome example of how God, how Jesus walked this earth. He was very God and very man, and he showed us how to do it. All right? He showed us how we can walk in love and forgiveness. Right? Every time we say, no, I will not do that. We can always go back and peer back in the times of back in when Jesus walked the earth and when he suffered and died and rose again on the third day with all power, but he did it for us. If he could do it, and he's not commanding that we get crucified and be on the cross, stretching the cross. He did that once and for all. But if he could give his life for us, a little thing about forgiveness, we can do that. It's doable. We can do it. So sometimes we talk about offenses, how sometimes offenses come. As a matter of fact, we just said, we live this life, walk this life, situations are going to happen. Tempers sometimes flare, and it happens. But again, when you have knowledge, you have power, you can do better. All right, so sometimes we said offenses come to mature us and prove us so that we can really be the light, so that we can really show forth the salvation of God, so that we can even advance, move up. I mean, if God can trust us with a thing like temperament and emotions and relationship, if we can master those things, oh, God knows he can trust us with the next level. All right, so now I want to bring this point out to you. So I want you to listen very carefully. All right, now it says, woe to the unrighteous or the intentional, anyone who intentionally offends, all right, or by whom offenses come. All right, one translation says, no one gets away with anything. Be careful to anyone who intentionally hurts or abuses these little ones. Meaning, yes, children who are abused, but also those who are weak in the faith, or those who may be, you know, or be weak, all right? Whoever intentionally abuses or offends without repentance, woe to them, God said. Whoa, wait a minute now. Wait, you won't get away with anything. All right, that's all of us. We won't get away with anything if we intentionally, over and over offend each other. God deals with us. He will deal with that. So the best thing to do is come to repentance. Ask God to help us. Lord, I ain't right. This is not right. I got to do better. Lord, forgive me. I need to go back and make that right. In this particular case, no. It's not, you know, it's just not right. All right, it's not right. If someone says you offended me, go to them and say, I'm sorry. Not, well, you know, you don't know what you're talking about. No, say I'm sorry. Just say I'm sorry. I didn't mean to do that. Please forgive me. All right. So now, again, how we walk in forgiveness, we said that in Matthew 18, 15 through 16. First of all, you know, the Bible says forgive our trespasses. And then if we forgive or ask God forgiveness of our trespasses, he forgives us, all right? He forgives us. But say, for instance, that, all right, if you walk in trespasses and God says, tells us not to, then God says he won't forgive us. So we have to walk in obedience and walk in love. Matthew 18, 15 through 16, if your sister or brother sins, it says go to him in love. First, we're going to pray. We're going to pray, and then we're going to go in love. And if he refuses to hear us, then what you do? You don't go get, you know, some people who are going to side with you. We have a problem with that sometimes. We get people, only people who side with us. All right? We need somebody who's going to challenge me so I can grow. All right? Not a brawler, not a gossip, but somebody who's praying. All right? If they still refuse to hear in this second step, then you want to go after prayer, time of prayer, go to your church, your pastor, your leaders, and ask them to get involved. And then you're out of it. Let them handle it. All right? Last week we talked about unforgiveness, what unforgiveness is. So if forgiveness means to exonerate, clear the debt, wipe the slate clean, you don't see any speck of it left. That's what forgiveness is. Nothing but love. Nothing but the blood. Nothing but the blood. There's nothing but the blood. The blood cleanses. The blood washes. The blood makes us new. The blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus washes, cleanses us, makes us new. Though your sins be as scarlet, God says, Jesus says, I'll wipe them, I'll wash them white as snow. That's what forgiveness does. There's no trace anymore. Trace. There's no trace. No trace. There's no more trace. It's been cleansed. You can't find it nowhere. You can't find it anywhere. Forgiveness means to free your brother or your sister from prison. All right? Unforgiveness. Unforgiveness means that. It means to blame, condemn, hold accountable, to accuse. All charges remain to be treated as if the event just happened. That's what unforgiveness means. Every time we see them, we play it over and over again. Oh my Lord. Every time we see the person who offended us, we just replay it, instant replay in our mind, and we look at them, and they can tell that we're literally playing it over and over again. Because in our eyes, there's no love, there's no forgiveness, there's no warmth, there's coldness, and we simply are just so tied in to just sticking there and staying there, amen. And what we're doing, we're placing our brother and sister, we're locking them behind bars, we're keeping them shut up, we're shutting ourselves up, nobody's moving, we're restrained, oh my God. You know, when somebody's been accused of something and they've been to court and their judgment's been taken, has already taken place, you know, the charges, you're trying to get the lawyer to take and go back and to retry the case. And the judge say the charges remain. There is nothing I can do. This is a court. I'm thinking about a movie. This is a court of law. This is a court of law. The charges remain. That's what a forgiveness says. It says, I'm sorry. The charges remain. So unforgiveness is repeatedly letting your brother or sister know, I'm sorry. Charges remain in me. It is this way it is. It's what it is. I ain't moving. And you feel it. You can feel it. You can feel exactly what's going on with the person who refuses to forgive. To blame, condemn. And you want the individual to suffer. You want them to, let's just be real about it. We want them to feel the pain. Suffer. We don't care. We just want them to suffer. We want them to look good and come out on top and tell everybody, this is what happened, y'all. I said it happened like this. That's a shame. That's a shame. And they're supposed to be, this my sister, supposed to be my brother, supposed to be my auntie, my homegirl. And they did this to me. They did it to me. We want everybody to know. We broadcast it live all the time. Unforgiveness is the absence of love for each other. The absence of love for each other. 1 John 4:7 says, beloved, let us unselfishly love and seek the best for one another. Why? Because God is love, or love is from God. And everyone who loves, everyone who loves others is born of God. Born of God. If we love, we're born of God and know God. My God, we know him. That word know means intimate. Hey, glory, 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 glory. Hey, in an intimate way. In order to know him in an intimate way, I got to spend time with him. I got to spend time in his presence. I got to spend so much time in his presence that all the stuff that happened and all of the unforgiveness and bitterness, if I spend enough time in his presence, it still doesn't mean that it was fair. It still doesn't mean that was okay. It does not mean that. It means I have chosen. I've chosen. I've made the choice. I'm not going to walk in that anymore. And Father God, I allow you to apply the blood and remove that sting. Remove that thing that's in my flesh. My God, you know, when you stick and prick a rose and you go down the stem and those stems are very sharp and if you run your finger, you're going to get stuck and you say, ow, right? All right. So, you know, anytime that we are walking in unforgiveness, you know, it's like repeatedly being reminded, but we want to ask God to cleanse and remove that thorn, remove that sting, remove that thing out of us so that we can really walk in forgiveness. You know, we want to sometimes hold on, hold on to that thing. And oh God, we want to hold on to it. We don't want to let it go. But God said today, I want you to let it go. I want you to let it go. I want you to really live. You have not really lived like I want you to live. You have experienced joy. You've experienced some sort of joy now and then. But you want to know what I have waiting for you. I got my joy. I want to wrap you in the garment of praise. I want to wrap you in my love. I want to do a new thing in you. Will you let me? Will you let go? Will you let go? Let me handle the other individuals. Let me handle that group of people. Let me handle them. And you let it go. Let it go. Let it go. My Lord, Sunday. Let it go. Let it go. Let it go. Let it go. But God, you're saying, I don't want to let it go. Because if I let it go, I think I'd be vulnerable. Been there, done that. Oh, I think I'd be vulnerable for anybody, everybody to come on and just lay up on me and just take advantage of me and use me and abuse me again. Oh, God. Today, God said, this is your day. This is your day of salvation. Because I'm telling you, if you release that thing right now, today, you'll never walk that way again. Hey, I got your back. I got you. And you got to get me. And I want you to know that I love you so much. I love you. 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 I gave my life for you. And I'm telling you, I've already shown you. I've shown you the way. I am the way, the truth, and the life. Hey, God. Oh, my God. My God. Hey, let it go. 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 Transparent moment. One time, over 30 years ago, I was a teenager. And a little bit more than that, but I was a teenager. Somebody did something to me, and I'm like, I was just so, I really liked the person, but they did something, and what they did, they told everybody about it. You know, it was something I thought was kind of private, but they told everybody. People didn't even ask about it, and they just told everybody what happened. I mean, years, and they were still telling people about it like they were proud of it. It hurt me. It hurt. It hurt, y'all. It hurt. It really deeply hurt me. It hurt me. But listen, you know, it hurt me, and I just kind of buried it. I felt like, you know, like Joseph, our brothers, how, you know, they put him in a pit and sold him off to slavery, and he buried it for a while. But then he came back and realized when he saw his brothers again that it was still there, and he had to ask them to forgive him. But listen, it happened. They said some things about me. All right. It was a private matter, but they said it, shared it with people. It embarrassed me. I was hurt and I was very angry with the individual. So what happened was I tried to bury it, didn't think about them because we don't even live nearby each other. And there's nobody you know. So you won't be able to, who is that? Who's that one? Who's that one? You don't even know. You could never ever guess. You don't know. And it's not important. The important thing is this, that they hurt me. I carried it for a number of years. When I saw them, you know, I was cordial, but I did not want to have anything to do with them. Nothing to do with them. I didn't want anybody I knew to have anything to do with them. I didn't want anyone to ever be in their company. So this is what happened. One time, we both had a very mutual friend. And the friend says, you know, Althea, so-and-so-and-so-and-so is really having really, really a major health challenge. And they're going to be having surgery, so I need you to pray for them. I'm thinking to myself, out of all the people, out of all the people in the whole wide world, why are they going to ask me to pray? Why are you asking me? I'm like, I'm thinking to myself, I ain't praying for them. I ain't praying for them. I'm like, just inside. I didn't say it. Inside. I'm like, I'm not praying for them. And God says, so you're not going to pray for them? I'm like, oh, well, I guess I am. But I didn't feel like it. But I did. And not initially, but eventually I prayed for them. And I released them. Because they had me locked up. They had me in bondage. And in my mind, I had them in bondage. I had them locked up. All right? So I released them. And God stepped in and changed that thing around. Uh-huh. Yes, he did. So listen, we can also forgive. We can forgive our family members, loved ones, and our coworkers. All right? We can forgive them as well. All right. All we gotta do is pray before we go and just have a conversation in love. Amen. And bless God. We believe God. Things are going to turn around. So we talked about also last week, binding and loosing. What binding and loosing is. We know that, you know, in spiritual warfare, we talk about binding and loosing. We bind the hand of the enemy, his works, his actions, his involvement in our lives, in our loved ones' lives, in our friends' lives. And we ask God to, we bind him in Jesus. We have the authority to bind. And then also we ask God to release the blessings, release the free flow of the Holy Spirit to come in. All right. But also when we come before the Lord as believers in prayer, all right, but we have unforgiveness in our hearts. We have unforgiveness in our hearts, and we seek to bind whatever it is that's disrupting our lives. We want a job, need a this, need that, need God, we need answers, need God to do that. I bind in Jesus' name, Father God. I thank you for loosing your blessing. We said nothing's happening. Nothing's going to happen. We are restricted, all right, to expect God to move on our behalf. So, all right, so if we want God to move, we have to come into agreement and alignment because, see, everything we said, everything we need in heaven is already done. All we got to do is walk in forgiveness, stand in forgiveness, operate in forgiveness, and all we got to do is just go before God, and God releases, amen, what we need. All right. So we know we're to forgive 70 times 7, and that means limitless, boundless. God wants us to forgive how completely with our whole heart. The heart is the inner self, will, intention center, the soul of mind, the function of our thoughts, passions, desire, appetite, affections. We must be intentional in forgiveness. What unforgiveness does, we talk about unforgiveness, we're talking today about what unforgiveness does, what it does, what does it do? What does unforgiveness do? Right, not do anything? Yeah, it does. It does. Amen. When it comes to unforgiveness, in Matthew 18:23, it speaks of the king. Last week we spoke about the king who forgave his servant of a tremendous debt. Remember in Matthew 18:23-35, the king forgave his servant of a tremendous debt of $60 million. All right? And because he begged and he pleaded and he cried and he and all that, the king forgave him. Otherwise, he was about to have his family sold, all of his stuff sold, all right? And he was going to be forever in debt, and he was going to get his money. But the servant pleaded with the king. King forgave him of the $60 million debt, all right? But then afterwards, that same servant went out and found another fellow servant who owed him money. What did he owe? He owed him 100 denarii, which equals 100 denarii, which equals $137. Bible says he could not pay it. He couldn't pay. The servant could not pay his servant or his master the $137. What did he do? The one who had been forgiven much of $60 million, he threw the servant into prison that owed him $137. The Bible says, my Heavenly Father will also do the same to everyone. Because what happened, let me just back up. What happened was the king found out that the servant had put the pressure on his servant of $137. So then the king immediately said, okay, you're going to do this to your servant? I want my money now in entirety, $60 million. I want it now, all right? Until it's paid. I want you to pay it to me now. So what happened was the Bible says, my Heavenly Father will also do the same to every one of you if you do not forgive your brother from your heart. So if you've been forgiven of a tremendous debt, like this servant, all right, and you find someone else who owes you less. See, the principle of it is that usually whoever is forgiven much forgives more, forgives even more. Like the woman who was caught in adultery, God forgave her so much and she forgave. But in this story, the forgiven servant was very adamant about going to get what was due to him from his servant. So when we forgive, we gotta forgive from the heart, not the surface, but from the heart. The heart is what matters. When we stand, the Bible says, praying, when we stand praying, we forgive. How can you love me, God says, whom you've never seen, but you hate your brother? All right, so whoever is born of God loves God. Unforgiveness is restricting. Unforgiveness is restricting. We become susceptible to separation from God. How about premature death? Premature death? What? Are you kidding me? What are you talking about? It's not that serious. Well, medical studies prove that unforgiveness can hinder our health. It's that serious. The longevity of our lives, all right? The quality of our life can be cut short because of what? Unforgiveness. It can increase the stress hormones in our body. Unforgiveness can weaken our immune system. Unforgiveness can raise our blood pressure. It can also increase gastrointestinal disorders and other body pains. Now, am I saying that all sickness and all disease and premature death is due to unforgiveness? I'm not saying that. I am not saying that. But it's worth checking. It's worth doing an introspective check, self-check, on what's going on, what's really going on in our hearts. Like I told you back over 30 years ago about what, you know, I did not really deal with, but the Lord brought it back to me. And thank God for that friend, because I don't know how much longer it would have been until I addressed that in my own heart. All right. But in many cases, all right, sometimes it's hereditary. In many cases, sickness and premature death is linked to unforgiveness. We become susceptible to natural laws, prematurely, too soon. Too soon. We all know our body daily dies. But too soon is what we're talking about, prematurely. And it releases, unforgiveness releases a stream that others can drink from. And that's in Psalm 1:1-3, good or bad. We know if we're connected to the source, we release good things. If we're not connected to the source, we don't release good things. We release negative things. And others are drinking from us all the time. They're drinking from us all the time. Unforgiveness shows a lack of maturity in grasping the word. My God. It shows a lack of maturity in grasping the word. So if we're there, just simply stop what you're doing. Say, God, Father God, I'm sorry. I repent right now. I ask that you would cleanse me, purge me. I don't want to keep walking in this level of my understanding. I want to walk in your word. Unforgiveness puts our brother, as well as ourselves, in a prison or pillory. It puts us in a prison, restricts us. You know, in that prison, we're in certain square footage. We have to go when they say we can go. We have to move when they say we can move. We go to sleep and get up when they say we go to sleep and get up. We eat what they tell us to eat. We wear what they tell us to wear. We're restricted. We're constantly reminded every day we walk around with those boots and chains. Ah! Jesus! Oh God. It's not what you have for us. This is not what you have for us. This is not what you want for us. This is not your best. It's not your best. We want to release others. We really do. We want to release God. But some of us find it hard because we feel as though it's just a slap on the face. You're just going to get away with murder or get away with it, with whatever it is. But God says nobody gets away with anything. Nobody gets away with anything. I want you today to release. Release the hurt, release the pain. Glory. I got more for you. I got more for you. If you trust me. God, if you trust me. My God, trust me. God said, trust me. God says, trust me. Trust me with your heart. Trust me with your life. Trust me. I'm going to take you places that you've never been before. The prison is not for you. The prison is not for your brother. The prison is not for you, the prison. I died and I rose on the third day. I have the keys to prove it. The death, hell, and the grave, who desired to keep me or desired to keep all of those who were in a holding place. But I have the keys and unlocked the doors and the chains. Release them. Oh God. Oh God. Lord Father God, right now we repent. We lift up our hands. We lift up our hearts. We lift up our lungs. We lift up, oh God, our lives. We lift up our hearts right now. God, right now, every sin, every pain, every care. God, right now, unless you intervene. Somebody on this live right now, or somebody who's going to hear the broadcast, they're going to hear the re-airing. God, somebody might be on their way to premature death. Someone might be on their way, oh God, to walking, oh God, into a prison for life. Not necessarily a literal prison, but they're stuck, they're restrained, they're in this place, they can't move from left to right. They have to do whatever the enemy is moving them like a puppet, wherever he says, that's what they do. God, but I thank you right now, release, oh God, my brother and sister, release, oh God, right now, your people from this chains, from the chains, from the confinements of, oh God, this spiritual prison, these walls, oh God, these gates, these walls that have us locked in. God, right now we repent. Cleanse us, cleanse me from the top of my head to the sole of my feet. Oh God, I'm seeing somebody right now as you're lifting up your hands and as you're opening up your heart, you know you're falling back into the arms of Jesus. It's like, hallelujah, in the realm of the spirit, like you're free falling into the arms. Hey, God, he's catching you right now. Hey, God, he's catching you right now. Oh, God, he's catching you. He's catching you. Let him take care of you. Let him hold you. Let him embrace you. Let him teach you what you've never learned before. Hey, God, let him take you where you've never been before. I'm a witness that when you forgive, God will take you places. God will do the extraordinary. God will do what none other can do. Even those, oh God, who still refuse to forgive you, you still forgive them. Those who remind you, you still forgive them. Those who keep holding you, you still forgive them. Hey God, as you begin to connect to God, God's going to fill you up so much that you can still forgive. You can walk in love. You can walk in peace. God's going to fill you up. Fill you up to overflowing so that you can be a refreshing spring that everybody you touch, everybody you touch is filled to overflowing. Father God, I thank you in advance. I thank you in advance, God. Even for those, oh God, who don't know you, if there's anybody on this broadcast right now, anybody listening, anybody, oh God, who's listening, oh God, who doesn't know you, I pray right now in advance, oh God, that as we understand and know, we were born in sin and shaped in iniquity. But God, you are our advocate. You lived, died, rose again, walked this earth so that we might have a right, so that we, oh God, could learn. We could know you as our Lord and Savior. Father God, we all sinned and came short of the glory of God. But by you, oh God, through your precious blood, oh God, right now, you gave your life for us so that we could have life and that more abundantly. So Father God, although we may have sinned and we may be sinners right now, but we ask right now, we repent of the sin, and we ask right now in advance, oh God, we acknowledge that we are sinners. God, we ask right now, please, we repent. We ask that you would cleanse, purge us, wash us. We shall be clean. We shall be whiter than snow. Come into our life to live forever. Live forever, live forever. Live forever, live forever. Forgive, because we love trust you. We love you. We trust you. We love you. We trust you. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for this time. Bless your people. Anoint us, oh God. Anoint our hearts, our lives. Move afresh. Move amongst us. We give you all the glory, honor, and praise. In Jesus' name. Amen. We're going to turn it over to Elder Lavina. God bless you, Elder Lavina. Take it over.
God bless you, Pastor Al. Somebody praise the Lord in this place. Hallelujah. Father, we just thank you for this time. We thank you for this word. We thank you for this vessel, oh God, who could stand steadfast and unmovable in you and deliver this word. We thank you for this opportunity to grow in you, oh God. We thank you, oh God, for this opportunity to forgive others, to forgive ourselves, to be able to draw closer to you, oh God. We just thank you and we just praise you for what our ears have heard, oh God, for what our eyes have seen, for what you are yet doing in our space, oh God. We thank you. We touch not your glory, oh God. We touch not your glory, and we have such an expectation of that which is to come. We thank you, oh God, that today, oh God, somebody is coming out of the prison of unforgiveness. We thank you, oh God. We thank you, oh God, that you saw fit to give us this opportunity to partner with your Holy Spirit to just grow beyond that place we've kept ourselves potentially locked in for a long time. We thank you, oh God, for that opportunity. We thank you for this season. We thank you and we praise you and we bless you. Right now, we are in our portion of our service where we're going to get our announcements and move towards one of the best parts of the service, which is our opportunity time. So if the chronicler would put up our announcements as we prepare our hearts for our giving, and we'll also have our information for how we can give through our various streams. All right, as the chronicler is getting the graphic ready, I'm actually going to just verbally convey a couple of our announcements to you until the graphic shows up. Bishop already mentioned that next week we start our Brainwashed Revival. Please check our website, check the stream. You'll see the announcement. You'll see who's going to participate, and we are looking forward to having all of you participate. May 19th, 7:00, Bishop said it, Pastor William Spence, mighty man of God, will stand and deliver the word and open us up. Next, we'll go to the 20th on the 7:00 as well, and Pastor Sandra Morgan Holly will bring the word. And rounding it out on the 21st at 7:00 will be Pastor Jonathan Briggs. Please govern yourselves accordingly. This is a Kairos time. Our bishop doesn't bring just anybody before us to speak into our lives. And it's not by happenstance, but in this season, I believe and I expect a right now word to propel us into our future destiny. So govern yourselves accordingly. Please find the time to participate. One of our other announcements, Sister Roz is also asking that, Chronicle, you can just leave it up. I'm just making this announcement. Sister Roz is asking for all of our graduates. If you graduated in 2020 or 2021, please know that we have not forgotten you. Sister Roz has not forgotten you. She is looking for you to reach out to her and provide your name, provide what college, school, or course you graduated, got a certificate from, you moved up. If you're in elementary or high school, please reach out, let her know this information so that we can take this time to honor your accomplishment appropriately. Next, it is my understanding that one of the best days of the year is coming up, our bishop's special day. According to him, it's a national holiday, so we'll honor that. It's a national holiday. Chronicler, if you could show that, I greatly appreciate it. May 20th through the 27th, we're going to take this time to honor our bishop, to just love on him and let him know how much we appreciate God for giving us him. Best birthday of the year. If you want to send a present, you can cash app it to $ Bishop J. Charles Carrington, or Bishop J. Charles, excuse me. Please feel free, take this time, love on Bishop, let him know how much of a blessing he's been to your life. Next, we're going to move into our opportunity time. Life Builders Church considers it an opportunity to be able to sow into the kingdom of God, to bring our tithes into our offerings into the storehouse. We consider it an opportunity. We know that everything comes from God, and we just give back a portion of that which he's already given to us. So guys, we consider that an honor. We know that this is opportunity time. Chronicler, when you have an opportunity, if you could put up the ways that we can give. It's opportunity time. This is our declaration. Life Builders Church has generous and faithful tithers and givers. Your generous giving adds value to this ministry. So now is your opportunity to continue your generosity in giving. If you are giving today, we have several streams by which to do so. You can visit our website, which is www.lbcbaltimore.org. You can do this by PayPal, which is www.paypal.me/lifebuilderschurch, or through paypal.com, lbcministry@yahoo.com. And if you're giving by mail, you can mail it to Life Builders Church, Care Advantage, Inc., 100 West Road, Street 300, Towson, Maryland, 21204. God, we thank you for this time of opportunity. Father, we ask that you would just bless everyone as they sow into your kingdom, oh God. We ask right now that you would just begin to pour out your blessings upon them, oh God. We thank you for this opportunity to sow seeds into the kingdom. We consider it blessed, bless every life, oh God. God, you said in your word that you would give seed to a sower, oh God. So we decree and declare that you would give seed to your sowers, oh God, that you would just begin to bless it, that it would be pressed down, shaken, and running over, oh God. In Jesus' name we pray. We thank you right now, oh God, that we have come together and that we've worshiped at your holy hill, that we have just soaked in your presence, that we have just had an opportunity to lay down all our sundries and weights. Any unforgiveness that was weighing us down, we thank you for this season to just release it. We thank you for this opportunity to just grow in you. Father God, we know that we can't be blessed. We can't be the fullest that you have for us to be if we don't release these things. So we thank you, oh God, for this time to release it. And we expect that as we exchange our cross for your cross, oh God, that it's easy. That it's easy. Father, we forgive ourselves if it's anything that we haven't been able to get beyond something that we've done in our past, some decision that we've made, some place that we've gone that we now understand that that wasn't the right direction, that wasn't the right choice. We forgive ourselves, oh God. We forgive our brother, we forgive our sister, we forgive that person who has long since gone, oh God, and they don't even know what the offense is. God, in some instances, we don't even know what the offense is, but we know that pain is still there. We know, oh God, that today is a day that you can release all of that, that you can remove all of that, that we have an opportunity to place it at your feet and leave it there. So we thank you, oh God, for that safe space to be able to place down those things, some of which we carried for a long time, God, to just release it and leave it there. We thank you. We thank you. We honor you this day. We thank you for this opportunity to have been able to worship together, to worship you, to honor you. God, we thank you as we leave this place and we go forward, that you, God, go with us, that you would be in the midst of us throughout this week, oh God, that you would begin to open doors that need to be opened, oh God, and close doors that need to be closed as we move forward in you this week. As we close this spirit out, we do it in like fashion. We know that God is always with us. Chronicler, if you'll put up our closing declaration, please. God dwells in the midst of Life Builders Church. God dwells in the midst of a blessed community. Grace and peace be unto you, and peace be multiplied. Have a blessed week. Join us for prayer every day at 6:15. Our intercessors are on the line. You can join us at 1-605-475-4700, access code 585263, #. Wednesday night's impact group. Please join all names, www.meetgoogle.com/JTN-GGBK-DFW. Google Meet, meeting code JTN-GGBK-DFW. Our Financial Peace University is ongoing as we speak. It started on the 6th. It's every Thursday night at 7:30. It's a 9-week course, so even though we're in it, there's still time to register and enroll. The cost is $129.99 per family. That's per family, not per person. That includes all class material. Registration is still open at www.fpu.com, 113-6656, and we think Alpha Kappa Alpha for partnering with us to bring this vital option to the community to grow in financial wisdom. We're so grateful for that partnership.